Hi guys, and welcome to Selection Sunday for the NCAA 2020 Men's Basketball Tournament. I had a pre-selection Sunday show, which explained how this format will work. So if you want to understand what's going on, I would suggest you view that video. Here's a quick recap. What you're seeing are not the teams that are going to be in the tournament. They are going to be selected before your very eyes in this show. I'll try and do it as quickly as possible, but remembering it's in real time and it's a video game format, it may take time to do this video. I'm not even sure how long it'll take. So each region has been staked out. The Midwest Division is the top region. And I explain which regions are the 2, the 3, and the 4 in the pre-selection show. So without further ado, here's the number 1 overall seed in the 2020 Men's Basketball Tournament. The Kansas Jayhawks. And the team that will be playing the Kansas Jayhawks will be and this is my 16th seed. Kent State. Okay. The number 2 seed in this region will be, and the number 1 overall 2 seed will be, trying to give you a feel of how it would feel if this show was actually broadcast. So I'm not announcing anything until I reach close to the name. You may be able to figure it out before I get there. Number 2 overall is going to be Baylor. Now the number 3 overall The number 3 overall seed will be Oregon. Your number 3 overall seed in the first region. Number 4 overall seed will be Auburn. Okay. The number 5 overall seed will be, in this first region, will be Colorado. The number 6 seed will be in this first region. Texas Tech. The number 7 seed in this first region will be Michigan. The number 8 seed in this region will be Florida. The number 9 seed in this first region will be Arizona. The number 10 seed in this region will be SMU. The number 11 seed in this region will be Arizona State. The number 12 seed in this region will be Davidson. The number 13 seed in this region will be Alabama. The 14th seed in this region will be Pittsburgh. And finally, the 15th seed in this region will be? Mississippi State. Now, the next region will be, and I got to go to my notes here, so excuse me, because I kind of botched this a little bit, but it shouldn't take that much time for me to get the correct paperwork here. It's my fault. I should have had it right before me. Okay. I don't know how I did this. There it is. Sorry about this delay, but I just want to make sure I state it correctly. I don't want to misinform you. So the next region will be, and that's what I was looking for in my notes here, the East region. So all of the number two overalls will be in the East region. Okay. So the number one in the East region will be the Dayton Flyers. The number two seed in this region will be San Diego State, the number three team in this region will be the Wisconsin Badgers. The number four seed in this region will be Creighton. The number five seed in this region will be Villanova. The number 6 seed in this region will be Houston. The number 7 seed in this region will be VCU. The number 8 seed in this region will be Yale. The number 9 seed in this region will be St. Mary's. The number 10 seed in this region will be excuse me as I took a sip of coffee here. Number 10 in this region will be Iowa. Number 11 in this region will be the Catamounts of Vermont. Number 12 in this region will be Cincinnati Bearcats. Number 13 in this region will be Akron Zips. The 14th seed in this region will be Wichita State. You made it. The 15th seed in this region will be BYU, Brigham Young, Cougars. You made it. And I didn't announce, which I should have, the beginning of the video, I mean of this region, I should have announced the 16th seed for this region will be Penn State. And that completes the East region. The next, the third region for the third number one seed, third number two seed will be the West region. The number one overall pick in the West region will be the Florida State Seminoles, the number 16th seed in the West region will be the Hofstra Pride. I don't know why I can't pronounce that right. Hofstra Pride is your 16th seed in the West. If I mispronounce it, I'm very sorry. The number two overall seed in the Western region will be just checking my notes to be sure here. Duke. The number three seed in the West will be Illinois. The number four seed in the West will be double checking here. Kentucky Wildcats. The fifth seed in the West will be Seton Hall. The number six seed in the West will be? Oklahoma. The number 7 seed in the West will be LSU, the Tigers. The number 8 seed in the West will be the Bradley Braves. The number 9 seed will be USC. The number 10 seed will be Rutgers. The number 11 seed will be Rhode Island. The number 12 seed will be Butler. The number 13 seed will be the Billikens of St. Louis. The 14th seed will be Utah State Aggies. You made it. The 15th seed will be UMass, the Minutemen. You made it. Okay, now we go to the fourth and final region, which will be the South. And the number one overall seed in the South region will be Maryland, the 16th seed, in the South region will be St. John's Red Storm. You made it. The number two seed in the fourth region will be Gonzaga. The third seed in the South region will be the Louisville Cardinals, the fourth seed in the South region will be Arkansas Razorbacks. You made it. The fifth seed in the South region will be Virginia, the sixth seed in the South will be West Virginia. The seventh seed in the South will be NC State, you made it. The eighth seed in the South will be the Bruins of UCLA, the ninth seed, will be in the South. The Stanford Cardinal, you made it. The number 10 seed in the South will be East Tennessee State Buccaneers, the 11th seed in the South will be the Richmond Spiders. The 12th seed in the South will be the Bonnies of Saint Bonaventure. Saint Bonaventure, you made it. The 13th seed in the South region will be the Liberty Flames, you made it. The 14th seed will be in the South region. Northern Iowa Panthers. And the last team to make it in And we may have to go to the videotape for this one because I came up one team short, being honest here. So I got to go to my original chart and pick an alternate. And this will be the last team in. The last team in the 2020 men's NCAA basketball tournament for this year of 2020. The last team, number 15 seed in the South, will be Radford, the Highlanders, you made it. And ladies and gentlemen, that is the completion of the 64-team tournament for the NCAA men's basketball tournament that would have been held this March and still will be held in a virtual world, video game world, beginning today. Here are your four number one overall seeds. And I'm going to go in order of appearance as they should be. Your number one overall is Kansas. Your number two overall is Dayton. Your number three overall and lost my place in line. Is Florida State. And your number four overall is Maryland. So those are your four number one seeds. And if you want to review, you can go back and look and see who and how they were seeded. And I know some of you are disappointed that your team didn't make it. Some of you are very angry with me right now, saying, how could such and such make it, and we didn't make it? And that's the way it goes in the real deal, too. This is the virtual world, and the fun thing about it is you can make up your own tournaments as you see fit and play these games using any of the NCAA basketball tournament games from 2001 until 2010. So this is a subjective view of who I believe should have made it into the tournament. And hopefully you agree with most of my picks. I know you ain't agreeing with them 100%, but it was fun to do, and it'll be fun to play. Now, what I'll be doing as this video ends is I'm going to select every team as a CPU team. I mean, as a user team. And I'll do so like this. You see how it appeared? And I could do that and show you that, but that's kind of boring. And then the tournament will begin. So look for games to start going up today. There'll be 10-minute halves, so there'll be low scoring, but they should be action-packed. I cannot tell you who's going to win this tournament. I could tell you who I think should have won the real tournament, but I'm not going to do that either. we'll leave it all up to the CPU, and most of us know most of the time we disagree with the CPU. But it should be fun. It's better than having no tournament, guys. And I hope you'll enjoy it. Thanks for watching. And continue to watch. And continue to share with the B&B crowd, the beer and bong crowd on college campuses all across America, this tournament. This is in the spirit of fun. Somebody has taken the time to actually do the tournament for you. I would say 99% of the players that were in the real game, I mean in the real NCAA teams that have been selected, are on these rosters. I may have missed here or there, but remember, this is all in the spirit of fun. Most of them will have their starting lineups or a reasonable facsimile of the starting lineup. So once again, enjoy, guys. Thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it. And like I said, please share this across all the colleges in America. It's got to be fun, even if your team doesn't win at all. And it might be a Cinderella in the bunch. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye now.